friends, today I'm going to show you a surgery which involves a six-year-old girl. She had a radial head dislocation 3 weeks ago. And if you look at the x-ray, there is a radial head is dislocated. If you draw a line, it's not going through the capitulum. And normally you see this in Monteggia fracture. However, on this occasion, there is no fracture line. And the consultant who saw this patient initially failed to recognize this, and she is now 3 weeks down the line complaining of pain and inability to flex past 90 degrees. If you look at the ulna, there is a clear bowing of ulna, and this is called plastic deformation of ulna. And effectively, the ulna should be straight, now it is bowed. Due to this, the length of the ulna has become short, which happens when there is a fracture of the ulna. In this case, there is no fracture. However, because of the bowing, the ulna has become short and radial head has dislocated. If she had come to me initially at 3 weeks, then I would have tried to manipulate it and gain ulna to length and put her into a plaster. However, she is now 3 weeks down the line. If my plan is to do an ulnar osteotomy, increase the length of the ulna, and hopefully that will reduce the radial head. However, as it is 3 weeks down the line, there is a good chance this may not reduce and we may have to perform an open reduction. So now we are ready. We have prepped the patient. We have draped the patient. Patient is supine. We have put a small tourniquet. Now I am going to use the C-arm to identify the apex of the plastic deformation of the ulna. And the apex will be the site of my osteotomy, so that we can get the ulna straight and gain the length, and hopefully this will fall back in place. So we tried to reduce this close, but as expected, it has not fallen back in place. The radial head is dislocated. I have now marked my skin incision at the apex, and if you look at the C-arm, I have marked my skin incision after checking the apex of the plastic deformation, so that I know where my osteotomy will be. Next step will be to open the ulna, do an osteotomy. So I'll just, I won't take you through the step of how I reach the ulna. I'm sure you know that. Once I reach to an osteotomy stage, I'll join you. So now I have made my incision directly over the ulna, as you would do for any ulnar shaft fracture. This is extensor carpi ulnaris and this is flexor carpi ulnaris. I have gently reflected it off. My skin marking is showing me the site of osteotomy. I am going to make an oblique osteotomy so that even when I lengthen it, there is some approximation of bone and the bone will subsequently heal. And once we gain the length, hopefully radial head should fall in place. However, I am less optimistic on this case because it's 3 weeks down the line. And there's a good chance we may have to open it. So now I've just made part of the osteotomy. When you're making an osteotomy, do make sure that you have got a homon on the other side, because intraosseous membrane and vital structures are not far away from the bone. You can see this bone is very narrow. It's like a metacarpal of an adult, in fact narrower than the metacarpal. So extremely cautious while you're doing an osteotomy. So I'm just using the saw and I'm protecting it with my homon. And the last bit, I will use a McDonald to just break it. I think we need to do a little bit more. So my advice to you is to preserve the periosteum. Now I have used the saw, you can see the periosteum is reflected now. On this side it has reflected it more. And do a controlled break. So use something. Now this osteotomy is complete. You can see it's opening up. So next step will be to gain the length and put a plate on top, and let's see whether it reduces our radial head or not. Finger crossed. What I have done is I have put two screws on the proximal fragment, and because we have done the osteotomy, I want to put the plate on the tension side. I put two screws, which is in good alignment. Now I am going to do an indirect reduction and gain the length. And once I have gained the length, and I will hold this with the bone holding forceps,
and then we will see whether it reduces the radial head or not.
I had shown before, I have put two screws on the proximal aspect and we tried to gain the length by traction and it was not opening at all. So all I have done is to reduce the osteotomy site using this low profile plate, and I have used this clamp and I hyperflexed the elbow. And as I hyperflexed, you can see that the fracture site has, or the osteotomy site has now opened. Now this signifies that this is the length that we have gained now, which was short before. And let's see whether after gaining this length, whether the joint has reduced or we will have to do an open reduction. So now looking at the C-arm, I'm quite pleased that this joint has nicely reduced and I don't have to open the joint and do an open reduction, which will be good for this girl as well. So now next step will be to put the screw in the distal aspect of the ulna in the position where we have gained the length. So now this is our final fixation. You can see we have gained around 2 mm of length. Some of the length would have come as we have reduced the bowing of the ulna. And I'm delighted to say, if I show you, previously this elbow was only bending up to 90 degrees, that too with a lot of force. Now you can see it's bending, flexing completely, extending completely, full pronation, full supination. So excellent result. I'm just going to close it down layer by layer as you would do for any plating of the ulna, and I'm going to immobilize her for around 2 to 3 weeks, after which I'll start mobilization. So this is the final view before closure. Now you can see the radiocapital line is nicely aligned. So I think it's an excellent result. So this video was about osteotomy of ulna for a 3 week old radial head dislocation. Thank you for watching the video.